Hey there, everyone. This is Ann Klemmer from stamperdog.com. And in less than 5 minutes, we're going to use one layout to make two different cards. And we're going to give you some tips to use with your stamparatus. Yeah, that's going to make this really fast. I'm starting out with a piece of 4 by 5 1/4 designer series paper that just is released today. And we're going to use the basic border die to go and cut it approximately in half. Now, nobody is really measuring exactly, but I put them into two piles because I made several of each card. Now, here's my folded card base, and then see how we're going to layer them on there? But that is not the big tip for today. You know, I'm using my Stampin' Seal, and if it ever doesn't start for you, just go and rub it across the back of your hand. Works every time. Well, almost every time. But once I learned that, I really loved it. When you layer this onto the card base, just make it even on all sides. The stamp police aren't watching, so you know, if you're a little bit off, I won't tell. And of course, we did that to the other one as well. Now it's time for the stamparatus. Now I went and stamped this already onto 1/4 sheet of very vanilla paper. It could be white. Yeah, no, it looks very vanilla to me. But look at, you know, once I cut it out, I went and cut it in half on the angle. And yes, I used the trimmer to do this. And I'm going to secure the what's left down onto the base of the stamparatus. This way, I went and cut out a whole bunch of the die cut. And then all I do is just layer it up into those cut edges, and now I can make several of them at one time, like I'm about to do now. By doing it this way, and yes, we're using that new Eden's Garden suite that is just released today. So by cutting it in half, we don't have all those fancy edges. Well, it takes longer to go and lay it down in that template. So by cutting it in half, all I have to do is match up those sides. Now, if you look, where I have the one cut on one leaf on one side and the two leaves on the other, that's the easiest one to do. And then, I put that Eden's Garden stamp case underneath the plate on the left-hand side, or arm, whatever you want to call it. And that helps me to where I can ink it up very easily. Pop it off, boom. And I did 18 of these rather quickly. Is that cool or what? So now we're going to take these and we're going to go and put some dimensionals on there. Now, do you take your covers off as you put them on, or do you put all the dimensionals on and then take them off? Now, I, to save time, and because I might forget otherwise or might miss one, I go and take them off as I go along. And look, magically, I've got all of them done. So see how they're evenly spaced, and take the outside ones as far out to the edge as you can without going over. Now, the sweet thing about this is there's no perfect place for you to put the greeting. You can put it high, you can put it low. These, I put them in the same general direction, but not in the same place. And I could have put them on the top. I could have put, you know, I mean, yeah. But like I said, no one's measuring here. Now, here are those great gems that come in the Eden's Garden suite, and they're just perfect to set this off, because it's really, if you look at it, a rather plain card, but that's okay because a little bling helps everything. And when you're making a large amount of cards, you want them to look like you dedicated yourself with sweat and tears over hours, but it's great when you can do it in just 5 minutes. Oh, golly. Yeah, well, there's a pair of cards. We've done it. This is Ann Klemmer from stamperdog.com. We hope you join us live Monday, Wednesday, Friday at 5 p.m. Yeah, live at 5 Pacific.